The combined effects of the southwest monsoon and a low pressure area seem to bring rainy weather across the country this week. Let's get more details from Pagasa weather forecaster Obet Badrina. Obet, what do you have for us? Good morning.
Good morning, especially to all our televiewers. So, it's the latest about regarding our weather. As of 3 a.m., the low-pressure area that we're monitoring is located now at 635 kilometers east of Infanta in the province of Quezon. So, because of this low-pressure area, areas in eastern Visayas, Dinagat Islands, Surigao provinces, Bicol region can still expect a generally cloudy skies now with some scattered rain showers and thunderstorms. Meanwhile, other parts of the country, particularly in the western side of Luzon and Visayas, these are the areas of western, including the central Visayas, Imaropa, as well as some areas of in northern Mindanao and Zamboanga Peninsula can still expect cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms. This is due to the southwest monsoon or hanging habagat. Here in Metro Manila and other remaining parts of our country, we can still expect a generally fair weather in the morning, but expect also the occurrences of rain showers and thunderstorms in the afternoon and in the evening. So these are caused by localized thunderstorms, which can last up to 1 to 2 hours. So regarding the low pressure area located east of Luzon, as of now, based on our latest data, there's still a slim chance or low probability or low possibility of development into a tropical depression, but we're still continuing monitoring the this particular weather system. So that's the latest in our weather from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center, Obet Badrina reporting.
All right, thanks for that update, Obet Patrina.
Clearing operations continue in Banaue, Fugao, where several areas are still reeling from a landslide caused by bad weather. Authorities on the ground believe it could still take them more than a week to clear all the debris. Around 1,000 families are affected by the landslide. 6 people have been injured. 3 homes were totally damaged, while over 1,000 were partially destroyed. The world-renowned tourist spot, the Manawi Rice Terraces, was also not spared.
Kami, mga rectorship. May konti lang siguro. Hindi pa namin nababalidate. Pwede ko namang ilist yung advisory notice. Pasabog naman yung kalsada, bumalik na yung kuryente. So, consider lang namin kung yung availability ng water supply. Na-damage din yung water district dito sa amin. Kaya 4 na araw, wala pang tubig. I recommended already to the DPWH kung ano pa ang pwedeng magawa nila sa mga invulnerable and canals, expansion program nila dahil national roads naman ito.
Relief operations are also ongoing in Banaue, but one vehicle carrying volunteers figured into a road accident. The driver of the vehicle died while 3 passengers were injured. The investigation showed they were on their way down from Banaue when they hit an oncoming 10-wheeler truck.
Social Welfare Secretary Erwin Pulfo clarifies his department is not distributing food packs and relief goods through non-government organizations. This after boxes marked with the agency's logo were spotted in a Facebook post of NGO Angat Buhay during its relief operations in floods and landslide hit Ifugao. Pulfo says based on their initial investigation, the food packs from BSWD and the relief goods from Angat Buhay were gathered in one warehouse by the local government unit. The Angat Buhay NGO was launched by former Vice President Lenny Robredo, who ran and lost to Bongbong Marcos in the May presidential elections. President Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. opened to making the wearing of face masks optional when it is already safe to do so. But in order to get to that stage, Marcos emphasized the importance of ramping up the country's COVID-19 booster uptake, especially for children, as his administration plans to fully allow the resumption of in-person classes this year. He's looking at local officials to lead the charge in strengthening their respective booster campaigns.
Gawin natin itong booster rollout at makakatiyak tayo. Wala nang lockdown. At ayaw na namin magkaroon ng lockdown. At pagka maging matagumpay ang ating booster rollout, ay makikita naman natin, siguro pwede na natin ibaba ang mga alert level, pwede na natin gawing optional ang mask. Pero hindi po natin gagawin yan hanggang maliwanag na safe na talaga.
The League of Provinces of the Philippines ready to heed the call of President Marcos to strengthen the rollout of boosters in the country. The group's president, Marinduque Governor Presbytero Velasco Jr., says they are already looking at possible ways to encourage their constituents to get the additional COVID vaccine doses.
Inganyohin natin yung ating mga rural health units at ang ating mga doktor na talagang pagpalakasin yung pagbigay ng booster shots at nagbibigay na nga kami ng incentives at alam namin importante itong booster shot. Palalakasin namin ito sa mga provincial governments.
Based on the health department's vaccination dashboard as of Saturday, only 15.2 million Filipinos have received the COVID-19 booster shot out of the more than 70.8 million individuals eligible for it.